he's kind of a world-weary figure, I suppose, in Diana's life, at least, in Wonder Woman's life. And he's seen a lot and seen the ravages of the First World War. Not much is given in terms of his backstory, but you can tell that he's just seen a fair bit of pain. Sometimes in films with the group, let's say, surrounding the protagonist, they're not always kind of fully fleshed out. You don't really understand why they're there. They may have some funny quips, but they don't really do much of anything. And these guys, us, each one of us has a different prism through which they see the world, and they all really, really complement our lead in Diana so beautifully, I think. And they're all so well-rounded. They're all such great actors. Patty is a pretty incredible human being, and to sit across from her and to hear her, I mean, she acted out essentially the entire film for me. I'm over the course of 2 hours at lunch, acted out the entire film. And she is so passionate, and she is so specific, and she's so articulate. I pretty much would have said yes just for her alone. I think that's the beauty of what Gal has, is that she is physically very imposing. She's stunning. She's like 6 feet tall. She's super strong, kind of emotionally, and her presence is very captivating. But she also, at the same time, has this beautiful spirit to her that's very, and I know she hates me saying this, but it's like, it's not childlike, but it's very open and warm and inviting, and she's got a wonderful maternal quality to her, and a deep kind of love for the world, and that is very much this kind of juxtaposition of Diana, Wonder Woman, in this film. At every mention of Ares along the way that Diana throws at him, that she has to meet the God of War and defeat him, I think it's so beyond his conception of what the world has to offer, of a world of magic lassos and people that can jump, you know, five stories, and people that can run across no man's land and single-handedly defeat everybody in a leather miniskirt, that I think that the idea of the God of War is just that much farther out there, and he just throws it aside and says, you obviously can kick some major ass, please help me do that, and then we can figure out this obsession you have with this, you know, this God of War character. It's a very modern telling of this story. It's beautifully rendered. And it has a pretty wonderfully, beautifully transparent message of that no matter how ugly this world gets that we live in, no matter how much death we encounter, no matter how many homicidal dictators are out there, no matter how much genocide happens, how many wars happen, there is still hope in the best parts of ourselves to be good and to protect one another and to do right by one another. That's what we should hold on to, and that's what she represents. So she's not just your regular, I guess, everyday superhero that just because of X, Y, and Z capabilities with, you know, capes and whatever, that they can defeat the bad guy. Not only can she defeat the bad guy, but she has a powerful, loving spirit aside from that, that is, you know, she's a savior in many ways, you know. She sees the best parts of ourselves.